Hello and greetings from Iceland. I have two main topics today, and one of them is the situation by Grindavik, what to expect. But I'm starting with the earthquakes on the Reykjanes Peninsula, since as some of you might remember from my last update, there is a certain underlying earthquake risk near Reykjavik, so it was no surprise when a magnitude 3.1 tectonic earthquake struck this morning, and it could be felt in some places in the city. And this weekend could be interesting, since a magnitude 3.4 earthquake struck offshore this afternoon, but I cannot say if there is any connection between those earthquakes. But when we look at the earthquake map today, I see very clearly all this unusual activity on the east part of the Reykjanes Peninsula, way more than usual. And experts have expected that when the eruption chapter near Grindavik comes to an end, the seismic activity will move elsewhere, follow the plate boundaries, and the most logical guess right now would be a transfer to the east. And those two spots, where most of the seismic activity is now, they are the places of interest. And the seismic activity on the west part of the peninsula, it has been extremely low for some time now. But while I was making this video, there was this uptick in offshore seismic activity. And as I've often noticed before, earthquakes out there are often followed with earthquakes on the west part of the Reykjanes Peninsula, where we already see some uptick in seismic activity, not far away from the island Eldey. We still have this science debate going on. Like, I was listening to Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson in the radio just days ago, where he was saying again that he believes that this chapter by Grindavík is coming to an end. At the most, it would be one more eruption, but likely not though. And his arguments are that the inflow into the lower magma chamber, the main source that had been feeding all those eruptions through the upper magma chamber, is decreasing. And two other scientists came with more and less the same conclusion recently, using data from the Met Office, that has been saying all along that this is not coming to an end. So this is more and less a debate about how to interpret this data. And Professor Þorvaldur and his colleagues are saying that the curve showing the rate of inflow has been gradually changing since this started. There may, however, be some temporary changes between eruption and such, but the long-term development that they are looking at is, according to their own studies, saying that the inflow to the lower magma chamber will come to an end by the end of summer. And one of those three scientists who claims this to be so is Haraldur Sigurðsson, volcanologist, that predicted the end of the 2014 eruption with good accuracy. And Professor Þorvaldur, he is best known for his quite bold statements, but the media loves to interview him because he's not afraid of speaking up and even get things wrong. And I think it's a good idea to listen to those scientists who have been putting their time and reputation into this. Because like I will get at later in this video, it is highly important to have some kind of long-term insight. And I feel as the Met Office owes us more explanations. Like, if those fine scientists are wrong, which could be the case, I would like to see them debunked with some evidence. But all I've heard so far is that they are not reading the data right. So I would like to know more. We are looking into the existence of Grindavík, short term and long term, and how we can avoid this ghost town image it's getting. And there is increased pressure from business owners in Grindavík to open up the town again, and I don't blame them. Big parts of the town are perfectly safe. The ground has already been scanned for hidden cavities, so we know what we are dealing with now. And one of the reasons why it remains closed is the short interval between eruptions. That's why there is no long-term planning, despite all those very expensive efforts to protect the town into the longer future. And we have also nationwide problems to deal with, like the tourism industry has not been growing this year. and the restrictions due to natural disasters in Grindavik, they are not helping us. But Grindavik could help the tourism industry. That is my opinion. Since despite all our problems, we were left with remarkable volcanic tectonic features in the landscape. So there has never been any doubt in my mind. Grindavik will become a major tourist attraction if it's allowed to go into that direction. And it's not just the local economy, it's the economy of Iceland that is saying we need to turn this situation in our favor and make sure that this town grows into something new. Although we are realistic and know that things will never be quite the same, but there is absolutely no reason to make Grindavik into a ghost town. And one more reason to breathe life into this town is a new report covering how the kids from Grindavik feel about this. And this has been hitting them bad. And the first words I read from this report was loneliness. They miss their friends. They are all over the country. And what the kids are asking for is a social center where they can meet up. And due to how many of them are on the Reykjanes Peninsula and in Reykjavik, with Grindavik midst between Reykjavik and the largest town on the peninsula, I think it's just one more reason to open up the town, connect it with bus services to the rest of the peninsula, so the kids can go back home to their old town every now and then, and do it in a town that has some flow of people going through, not the ghost town that it is today. And I think that Grindavik as an open town would be the best social center that we could provide those kids with, even if it's only temporary, because it might turn out that this chapter is not over, of course, but we do, however, now have a lot of knowledge about the safety boundaries, when to evacuate in time before the next event and such. And this is why I would like to have more experts to look into this, or the data that Professor Thorvaldur and his colleagues have been working on, or this long-term data about the inflow rate into the lower magma chamber. Is it correct? And we should not waste any time there. And we know for sure that, as always, this episode that we are going through by Grindavik, it is not here to stay forever. At some point in time, there will be good news coming from there, but we might get bad news elsewhere on the peninsula as well. But the earthquakes today, they are likely not a part of that. Although I do see them as interesting, especially when I look at the broader picture. So I will be looking at the seismometers every now and then, but I don't expect the big one as things look now. So I will just go on with my work. I have lots of new footage and all sorts of videos on the way, since the weather is a bit dull now. And I was very happy to see how you responded to my last video, the magma intrusion on the mountain. And a part of my plan for the summer is to go after footage like this, or when the weather gets a bit better, so I can hit the road again. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.